the Channel coast, the rude Atlantic's roar, the ocean knocking at our island door. Here is the friend that kept our foes afar. Here is the foe that made us what we are. The sea, the blue, the fresh, the ever free. We are an island people, a sea-going people. The way of the sea is in our blood. The fascination of small boats, of great ships, the call of the sea around us. And still, though steam may everywhere prevail, the wise young mariner begins in sail. In happy harbors under England's lee, we learn the skill that takes our ships to sea. Lovely ship. The world must own our worth while we can send such beauty around the earth. A ship's a little world, a city in the sea, a floating world in which we can drift to distant shores. This latest of the famous fleet of the Orient Line sails on the Australian run, 29 days from Southend to Sydney. Or cruises in summertime in the Mediterranean, the happy sea. As she sails, who wouldn't go with her? Who wants to be left ashore? Off the nab tower, it's goodbye to the pilot. Speed ahead. The ship's alone and free. A little world, a city in the sea.
Yes, we're a city of 1,500 souls, all told. And I, as captain, am responsible for the lot. Safety, food, health, their lives and their livers. A ship like this has as many departments, as many problems as a great hotel or hospital. I've grand officers and a fine crew. They're all as proud of the ship as I am. And I believe just as wedded to their jobs. Maybe we think a lot of ourselves up here on the bridge. But down in the engine room, we're only the deck department. Anyone can steer the ship, they say, but who drives her along? Now the ship is somewhere in the blue Mediterranean and the crew are in their whites. But where exactly are we? The deck department are finding out. The sun's over the meridian and we fix our noon position by the meridian altitude of the sun. We also, by the way, announce the distance run in the last 24 hours, on which some of the sporting passengers have a sweepstake every day. Why so many shooting the sun? Well, six pairs of eyes are better than one. A touch of democracy, you see. Besides, the navigating officer may fall sick tomorrow, and every officer must keep his hand in. At noon, I always take a sight myself. Now let's go down a deck or two. Ah, this is the life. Who was it wrote, "My wife is cooking in the sun, another day and she'll be done." He must have known his Mediterranean. Here is my excellent purser. and there's one man whose job I do not want. The purser is never seen on the bridge, but he may claim to be captain of trouble. He is, you might say, the ship's housekeeper, in charge of every tiresome thing from money to meals, tickets, passports, pay, supplies, steward's discipline, and passengers' complaints. The general rule is, when anything goes wrong, complain to the purser. And passengers have been known to consult him about their marriages. I deal with nature. The poor purser has to manage people. But he's still smiling. Here's our proud chef, for example. A master of craft who keeps us all contented. If he didn't, the purser would be the first to hear about it. Bit of a change after the salt pork and ship's biscuits of my early days. No wonder some of our lady passengers tell the chef he's wonderful. After all, he can do his shopping in half a dozen countries. Mallorca, unless the deck department have made a big mistake. Let go the anchor.
Palma, the capital of Mallorca in the Balearic Islands belonging to Spain. In the Mediterranean, every island, every port has a story centuries old. And here, hundreds of years before the name of Spain was heard of, came the Phoenicians, the Carthaginians, the Romans, and the Moors. The island's beautiful, the people friendly, and there's the rich wine, the gay music of Spain.